Hold on one second.
Tell me what you guys got.
Sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir.
Yeah.
So, why are you here?
Why am I here?
Why are you here?
It's not apparent.
Acts chapter 2.
You say it's not apparent. Ask your question.
I'm asking you. It's not apparent.
You're going to answer my question with the question?
Are you going to answer mine?
So you don't want to talk.
Look,
you're not really here for anything, are you?
Look, I'm going to tell you something.
Answer the question. Why are you here?
I just asked you a question.
Brother, I asked you a question. Answer the question.
I asked you a question.
Give me 1 Timothy. Give me 1 Timothy.
Everything that's here.
You don't really want to talk, do you?
For a reason.
What?
Are you afraid to deal with us? Are you afraid to actually have an intellectual conversation? Is that what this is right now?
Intellectual?
You just want to talk. You just want to yell over your little bullhorn, right? You don't want to actually.
I'm here all the time.
Okay, so let's converse. Let's converse. You keep repeating the same thing over and over. You notice where your mind is at?
Yeah.
Okay, so listen. Watch this. I ask you a question. Sir, why are you here?
You read the Bible all the time, too, don't you?
You notice you're afraid to deal with us because you don't know the Bible. Where's your Bible at, sir?
I don't need one.
You read it.
But wait a minute.
You read it. Sir, you read Acts 7 like you just said. You read it.
Hey, I just
You don't got your Bible.
Hey, that's right.
Why not?
First Timothy 6 and 4.
Watch this.
The book of 1 Timothy chapter 6 and verse 4.
Y'all sophisticated out here. Dango. Okay, brother, I'm going to step over here then real quick, huh? You need to get you one of these.
Go ahead.
He is pale. Knowing nothing.
That's you.
Acts 2:38.
Read it again.
Knowing nothing.
Sir, you came out here to try your best to disrupt what God has set up. Look at you. You say we don't know you. I'm going to tell you about yourself right now. You did your little time in the military, didn't you? How long was you in the military? How long was you a Marine? Where'd you serve? Why do you keep repeating the same thing? You can't deal with me, bro. That's my question. You did your time in the military, which is probably the highlight of your life. You are a lonely old brother now. You have nothing else to do on this Saturday morning, Saturday afternoon, but try to come up here and disrupt. Give me Isaiah 3:12. Brother, your life is sad, bro.
Let me tell you something. Your life is sad.
You actually could do better if you do what God said to do. Give me Isaiah 3 and verse 12. You're leading people astray, and that's if anybody's following you. Where's your school? Where's your church? Where's your school? Where's your church? Who's following you? Why isn't anyone listening to you, brother? Did that work with this brother that was standing up here? No, watch this. Isaiah 3 and 12.
Isaiah chapter 3 and verse 12. As for my people.
As for who?
My people.
Now, I'm actually questioning this brother's lineage. You must not be a jealous company in a fight. The way you acted and the way that your ears just stopped when the word of God came out. Now, I will say you do got that skill. You pretending you don't hear none of this, Bible. Read that again.
As for my people, children are their oppressors.
Read on.
And women rule over them.
Come on.
Are my people.
Read.
They which lead thee.
They which lead thee, your so-called leaders. You're supposed to be an older man. You're older than me. You're supposed to be teaching me something.
That's right.
It says, they which lead thee, read.
Cause thee to err.
Cause thee to err.
Is that in the Bible?
They cause you to err. Do you know why you can't teach anybody anything, brother? Give me Psalms 111 and 10. Psalms verse 1, chapter 111, verse 10. This is why you can't teach, brother. Watch this, read.
Psalms 111 and verse 10.
This could be my hat.
The fear of the Lord.
You hate this Bible, that's why you won't listen. You hate this word, that's why you won't listen. The fear of the Lord is what?
Is the beginning of wisdom.
That's the beginning of being wise. Come on.
A good understanding have all day that do his commandments.
This is why you can't teach, brother. This is why no one's listening to you. You charged up your bullhorn this morning. You woke up, you might have brushed your teeth. I don't know.
You know
put that old ass hat on and you came up here thinking you was going to stop something, brother.
Let me tell you something.
Read it again.
A good understanding.
Come on.
Have all day that do his commandments.
This is why you're biblically dumb, brother. You don't know the word of God because you won't keep God's commandments. We have to come out of these churches. Watch this. Now, hold on. I'm going to entertain it for a second. Yes, we know Sakari. What are you talking about? Why don't you want to talk about you right now? Because you're in the midst of sin. Why are you trying to point to everybody else, right? What about you? Why don't you keep God's commandments? Do you believe we have to keep God's commandments?
What come out against them?
They're
your brother. You love that sin.
You don't want it. You didn't come out here to talk. You came out here to do what? Repeat yourself and say the same crap over again.
And you're gonna say nothing about Sakara.
Are you intimidated by us?
Let me tell you something.
Then talk.
I'm gonna tell you something. I'm talking about Sakara.
Brother, you ain't talking about nothing. You ain't talking about the Bible. Sakara ain't got nothing to do with us. Are we Sakara?
Yes.
How are we Sakari?
Because we are Hebrew Israelites.
Sir, okay, so what, why did you do that at the Murrow Building April 19th?
Like all Christians
why did you blow up the Murrow Building?
Like all Christians are the same.
All Christians are the same, right? What the hell happened in Columbine? They were Christians. Why did you do that, sir? You see how dumb you sound?
What happened in New York?
You see how stupid you sound?
What happened to the
mass shootings and all the stuff Christians have done?
That's how this works.
Brother, you don't want to deal with me because you know you have nothing to say.
That's right.
Brother, watch this. Give me a First John chapter 2. Fundamentals. And we're
here
right
now.
This will be you without God's commands. This man, old, washed up, not doing anything. Look at his face. That is the face of defeat.
That's right.
Satan done kicked this man's ass up and down the block.
That's right.
He is out here doing the bidding of his father, the devil, now. He hates his people. Do you know? Hey, what about the Jehovah's Witnesses?
I've never lost nothing.
Hey, what about the Baptists, the Methodists? Why are you out here in front of us?
Because
you hate God. You hate God's people. You hate Jehovah's Foundation.
There
you
got that? Read. The book of 1 John is the 2 and verse 4. He that saith, I know him, and keep him not his commandments.
This is why this man is trying to quote scriptures, just like Satan, the devil, quotes scriptures. He ain't got nothing to say. He don't know the word.
And
he professes to know Jesus.
Only in the Bible that says talk about people.
And keep even not his commandments.
You keep God's commandments?
Brother, come on,
you don't keep God's commandments, do you? Yeah, we keep them right now. Name one I'm breaking. What law am I breaking? Uh-oh.
The Bible said don't pick up two sticks.
Say
the Bible
what?
Said don't go 100 yards.
Say it again. Stop. Don't ramble. The Bible said don't cook steaks. Sir, the Bible said don't cook steaks. Is that what you said? Now you want to move on from the dumb stuff you just said.
Give me another one. Tell me the
600
commandments you're supposed to keep.
Sir, I'll give you the Bible. Matter
come on,
watch this,
give me the
600
commandments.
Give me Matthew's.
Come on, you can't even do that, man.
What is it, 22? Two greatest commandments. Don't run, you asked the question. Don't leave now. I'm about to give you all 600 commandments.
I'm
ready? Are you listening?
Tell me the 600 commandments.
You got that? Read.
Matthew chapter 22, verse 36.
Tell me the
600 commandments. Which is the great commandment in the law?
Come on.
Jesus said unto him, thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, and with all thy soul,
come on,
and with all thy mind.
Why are you still running? You ask me a question, and I'm answering it. You didn't come out here to listen, brother. You came out here to be a distraction. And the only reason why you're getting any little show time right now is because everybody's kind of moving around. Oh, this brother listening? How we doing, brother? What's your name, bro?
What did he say?
Come up here, George. I want to talk to you, George. I'd rather deal with some problem. You can stand there, but watch this. What's your nationality, bro?
Do you believe that Jesus Christ got raised from the dead? You want children, so you can ask questions. Ask that question.
Hold on, we'll be back to
you. Let me tell you something.
Black. Let me tell you something. Has anybody ever told you you look like Jesus Christ?
That's right.
Has anybody told you that before? Bro, when I look at you, I see them here. My man, give me a revelation. You look like Christ, brother.
That's right.
It's a lie.
Watch this. You got that?
We're a liar from the beginning.
Listen to this, brother.
You don't know
Revelation chapter 1 and verse 14.
Come on.
His head. And his head.
You don't know my name.
Like
you see the hairs on your head and the hairs on your face, how they white? That's how Christ was, bro.
That's right.
Go ahead.
As red as snow.
Uh-huh.
And his eyes were as a flame of fire.
Come on.
And his feet like unto fine brass.
And his feet was like unto fine brass, bro. That's you.
They talk about Jesus, and they crucified Jesus.
But you know, we just saw people, some of our people don't want to hear it. Like my man here, you don't want to hear this Bible. And it's okay, because somebody got to be the devil. Somebody got
to
be the ones that's not going to make it. But we're going to do what God said to do. We're going
to
listen to the word of the Most High.
And watch this.
Now, Christ being a black man like yourself, with us having that understanding, it comes more to the story. Give me Matthew 5.
You know who do that?
Matthew, the 5th chapter and the 17th verse.
The Bible says
the world has taught us don't keep God's commandments, that the laws of God are done away with. He believes that. This is why he don't wear fringes. This is why he's marred his beard. You know what I'm saying? This is why he's out here prophesying with his head covered. When the Bible says a man dishonors the Lord whenever he prophesies with his head covered. You got that?
Matthew 5, 17. Matthew chapter 5, verse 17.
Go on.
Think not that I am come to destroy the law or the prophets. I am not come to destroy, but to fulfill.
Now, this knowledge is supposed to give you now a sense of self. This knowledge now is supposed to teach you and guide you. This knowledge will now show you what? I ain't the same as everybody else. And you move differently. You move according to God's word and not man's word. What we have to do is come out of man's ideas. Give me Jeremiah 17:5. Jeremiah 17, chapter 5, verse. Now, if I try to talk to him and ask him, prove that's not a law.
Let me tell you something.
Watch.
We don't keep the law.
Prove it. Prove fringes isn't a law. Prove
that you
get fringes isn't a law. You notice how you run from my question as I ask you? Listen, bro, this is why your wife left you, brother. This is why. Because you don't listen. You got a problem with listening. Is that what she told you before she left? Read, bro.
Jeremiah 17, verse 4.
Come on.
And thou, even thyself, shalt discontinue from thy inheritance.
We were disconnected, discontinued, cut off from our heritage for rebellion, just like this. Come on.
That I gave thee, and I will cause thee to serve thine enemy in the land which thou knowest not. For ye have kindled a fire in mine anger, which shall burn forever.
We kindled a fire against the Most High for being rebellious like this man.
Come on.
For not doing what God said to do. And he's prideful.
Tell me about those.
He's real boastful in the sin that he's in.
I mean, you talk
again, as a man, you should have some dignity.
To tell me some type
you should
of commandment.
Be able to say, you know what, all right, you ask me a question,
law,
that's
law, ceremonial law,
but they don't want to do that.
And commandments
they fear
that
this word. They fear 600. This word. But guess what? We're going to give it to 600. You regardless. Give me 2
you
know
Timothy.
2 Timothy, what is it, 4?
Tell me about what commandments supposed to be.
We just tried to tell you, but you don't really want to talk. You're scared. Stop being so scared. You're a grown man, dog.
You're the one who's shaking over there.
Brother, who's shaking really? Brother, listen to me. Be real and talk to me. Be real and talk to me. So, all right, now we're talking. We're going to 2 Timothy, the 4th chapter, the 3rd verse. Read.
2 Timothy, chapter 4, verse 3.
Oh, good. Listen, bro. Come on. That Bible hearts is like kryptonite, ain't it? Is it burned inside, bro? Read.
For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine.
Why are you talking over the Bible? Hold on, read that again. Maybe he loves, maybe he might love God. Read that again. He might be quiet for the word of God. Read.
For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine.
Why do you move every time the scripture's read, sir? What is going on? Is it hot?
Let me tell you something.
Is it burning inside? One more time, read.
For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine.
Come on.
But after their own lust, shall they heap to themselves teachers having itching ears. And they shall turn away their ears from the truth.
Is this why you keep stopping your ears, brother? Brother, what did that scripture just say? I want to talk about all of who's crucified Christ. Why won't you deal with me, bro? You keep changing subjects. Every time I deal with your matter, you change the subject. Read that again, bro. That's a sad brother. How old are you? How old are you, sir? How old are you, sir? How old are you, sir?
How old are you?
How old are you? I'm 38.
I'm 38.
Go ahead. What's how old?
I'm 38.
How old are you?
I'm 38.
Yeah, read that, bro. It burns, bro. Listen, man. Hey, listen, you need to get back on your medication, bro. Hey, I'm serious. I'm serious. I'm being real. I can tell. I see it on you, brother. I see it on you. Read, bro.
For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine.
Why won't you endure this Bible? What is so bad about the word of God? What's so bad about the word of the Most High? Read on.
But after their own lust.
After what?
Their own lust.
See, you want to live in the white man's kingdom. That's why you got the flag on your face, ain't it?
Right.
You love, hey, you love that you was a Marine, huh?
Right.
Or are you a groupie? You said earlier I might be wrong about you being in the military.
You're so intelligent.
Yeah, I know. So deal with it. Were you a Marine? Is this what you've done? Is this life? Is this your life, brother?
Huh?
We don't want to talk, bro. Stop playing with us, man. Is this a game? So talk to me, bro. Quit running.
Look,
quit running.
Acts 2:38.
Go to Acts 2:38.
Go to Acts 2:38.
Please.
Go to Acts 2:38.
So I'm meeting you halfway right here. Matter of fact, I've overstepped.
Let me tell you something. Oh,
hold on, look, I've overstepped.
I'm coming with you.
Reed, I'm right here with you, bro.
You're scared of me, right?
We're going to Acts 2.
You're scared of me, right?
Who's scared of
you? You're scared. I know. So, but you ain't stopping over the witness. I mean, come on, man. Don't be animated. You're trying to be animated.
I'm trying to meet you where you at, bro.
You're talking about me like a dog.
Listen,
bro. And now you're trying to sit up here.
You're damn right, because I saw you act this.
Let me tell you something.
Go ask too, because that's what you want. Go ahead.
That's right.
Go ask. Follow the line, man.
Acts 2:38.
Come on.
Then Peter said unto them, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ. For the remission of sins.
Absolutely.
And you shall receive the gift.
Hold on, wait, wait. We talking. See, man, we making strides now. Absolutely.
No, you haven't.
No, I haven't.
No.
How, didn't you just get through talking about bearing false witness?
That's right.
I just said I've been baptized in the blood of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ.
According
what do you say?
According to Acts 2:38.
Absolutely.
When?
What do you mean, when?
I'm not. What? That's English,
I've been,
right?
I've been, I've been in the truth since 2006. What about you?
Bring it out.
What truth?
The Bible, the Word of God. Give me Psalms 119, verse 442.
Bring it out.
Now we talk. Hold on, don't we got a good thing going. Wait.
We're still on Acts.
I'm coming back to Acts.
We're still on Acts. No, we're just staying on Acts.
Coming back to Acts, I promise.
Have you been baptized in Jesus' name?
Yes. Acts.
So,
I'm sorry.
Psalms 119, 142. And then you
start
to sweat. Because Psalms 119.
Because Psalms 119.
Hold on, wait, wait, wait.
Have you been baptized according to Acts 2:38?
In 2006, yes. Now let's read Psalms 119, 142.
You've been baptized in Jesus' name, and you spoke in tongues.
Book of Psalms 119, verse 142.
Come on, bro.
Wait, 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 hold on. I'm trying to help.
Come on, come on. Now I'm trying to help you, man.
Me and you can't dialogue.
I'm really praying that you be baptized
sir,
in Jesus' name.
You're jumping to different subjects.
No,
you don't know what the Holy Spirit is.
I've been in one subject all the time.
No, you haven't.
Yes, I have.
We read Acts 2:38. You asked me if I've been baptized in the name of Jesus. I say yes.
Come on.
So let's get about the truth. Psalms 119, 142.
Give an answer to all men.
Psalms 119, verse 142. Thy righteousness is an everlasting righteousness,
come on.
And thy love is the truth.
That's
right.
Brother, if you've been baptized in Jesus' name,
bro, why we are not talking about that right now?
It is a sign following that.
This is the truth. Read it again. Why do you keep blocking your ear?
A sign following.
Read.
Thy righteousness
is
an everlasting righteousness.
What is God's righteousness?
You know what a sign is?
Brother, I thought you were talking, bro.
Things coming on.
It's okay.
Yeah, no, I'm just letting you know.
It's going to be all right. So we're talking now.
Come on, man, let's make it.
We've gotten to a point.
Have you been baptized in Jesus?
You said Acts 2:38. I answered your question. My question to you now.
A sign follow Acts 2:38.
I thought I could help you.
Acts 2:38.
I thought you wanted to deal with me.
No, brother, you don't want to deal with me.
I just did.
You're walking away.
No,
you're walking
away. I'm going back
brother,
up here because
you don't understand because you don't want to hear.
Read Psalms 119, on, 142 again. Listen.
Psalms 119, verse 142.
Listen.
Thy righteousness is an everlasting righteousness.
Come on.
And thy law is the truth.
What is God's righteousness?
Come on, brother. What does Acts 2:38 talk about?
Deuteronomy 6.
Come on.
What is
Deuteronomy
6:25. Deuteronomy 6:25. Brother, hey, listen.
Have
you may not know this.
Baptized?
We don't hate you.
Have you baptized?
You may hate us, but we
come
don't
on.
Hate you,
come
brother.
On.
Look at me, now, look at me. I'm talking to you.
Hold up.
Brother, we don't hate you. We are
going.
Hey, hold on. 6:25. Read.
Deuteronomy 6:25.
You won't talk to me.
Why?
What did I do? What did I do to you that you won't talk to me?
Can you give me a minute?
Sir, we can give you plenty of minutes.
Wait, I just want to ask this
Deuteronomy
question.
Deuteronomy 6:25. I asked you a question, I'm going to answer.
Brother,
what is righteousness? Read.
Come on, brother, can I ask
and
you a question?
And it shall be our righteousness if we observe to do all of these commandments before the Lord our God.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Now you're talking so you don't hear the scripture.
I'm noticing the strain about you.
When the Bible starts going, you get to talking. Notice I be quiet.
I
don't talk. I'm going to do it again. Read.
You don't hate me.
Deuteronomy 6:25. And it shall be our righteousness if we observe to do all of these commandments.
Okay?
I told you that. What is God's righteousness?
Just like you said, you don't hate me.
I don't hate you.
But why you talk about me like a dog?
Because you are a dog, brother. That's how you acted.
No, the Bible says,
give me 1 Samuel 2 and
3.
I'm going to show you.
1
Samuel 2 and 3.
And like a pig turned to smoke.
You asked me a question. I'm about to answer you.
It's talking about Israel only. The only dog out here is you.
We ain't hurting you.
Because the Bible said, like a dog.
We ain't forcing you to be here, neither.
Where is that?
Why are you here? Where is your real love at?
That's how they're
read
Matthew, right?
1 Samuel 2:3.
This is why I talk about you like a dog. Read.
Talk no more to exceeding proudly.
Come on.
Let that arrogancy come out of your mouth.
That's what's coming out your mouth right now.
You're not a vomit, bro.
for the Lord is a God of knowledge.
God knows all things. This is why you were shocked that I knew about you. You were shocked that I knew about you, wasn't you? You was like, damn, I woke up this morning and had nothing else to do. Now I'm out here. Read that again.
For the Lord is a God of knowledge. And by him, actions are weighed.
By God, actions are weighed. That's how I move. That's why I spoke with you. You know why? Because of your actions. You out here, look at
that.
We got drug dealers, prostitutes, we got all types of stuff going on. But you're here. But you're here. Okay, what's that?
Because you're black.
What's you don't know what a black Hebrew Israelite is.
Yes, I do.
I'm not a black Hebrew Israelite.
Yes, sir.
You're lying. You're bearing false witness.
How is that?
I'm not a black Hebrew Israelite.
You're just Hebrew Israelite.
None of us are black Hebrew Israelites.
You're just a Hebrew Israelite.
Fix your face. I know you're it sucks right now, though. We are not black Hebrew Israelites.
Yeah, you're
so
Hebrew
the group
Israelite.
That you're claiming as black Hebrew Israelites, you need to apologize to us for associating us.
Right here,
again, we're not black Hebrew Israelites. It says Israel united in Christ, brother.
Yeah.
You forgot your glasses.
Black Hebrew Israelite.
Israel united in Christ. The Israelites are black. Fix your face, friends.
Yeah. So you're black
if you
Hebrew
listen,
Israelite.
You understand this stuff.
Let me tell you something. No, I understand it. You no, I understand that clearly. Like Christians. You understand Christians. All Christians.
Once
you
again,
all Christians
I can tell you
now,
about
right?
the different doctrines within
okay?
Christianity.
Yeah. Thank you.
Notice how I did that? Baptism, Baptist, Methodist, Catholics, Pentecostals, these things are just different nature, right?
Yeah,
okay, so who are we?
Where's the sign?
Who are we?
Black Hebrew Israelites.
Sir, you're lying. We are
you
not black Hebrew Israelites.
You got the same time.
What's that got
Blue
to do with thee? They got crosses.
Israel.
Did you just ask
Blue
about the cross earlier?
Israel.
You got that?
Yes, sir.
Got
read that.
Second Timothy,
you lacking, bro.
2 Timothy chapter 2 and verse 15.
Come on.
Study to show thyself approved unto God.
Have you done this, sir? Have you done this, sir?
Have you done
this? You was thinking about it? Answer the question, bro. Don't be afraid. Be real.
Acts 2:38.
Brother, we just read Acts 2:38. And it was to no avail for you. You asked me a question, and I answered your question. Now you want to answer this. Have you studied to show yourself approved?
Come on, brother.
If so, why aren't you wearing fringes?
Come on, brother.
Why aren't you wearing fringes? If you studied to show yourself approved. Why you keep repeating yourself and saying the same thing? You know what that is? That's a sign of an intellectual flaw, sir.
Right now,
you're not able to talk. Come on, bro.
Bro,
give me Numbers 15.
You, okay?
Tell me that this is evil.
On.
I want you to tell me if this is wrong. Numbers 15, 38.
You're not the black people. Like
Numbers chapter 15, right? Verse 38.
Read.
Speak unto the children of Israel and bid them that they make them fringes in the borders of their garments throughout their generations.
Why?
And that they put upon the fringe of the borders a ribbon of blue.
Why did they have to have fringes?
Tell me.
You know.
Boy,
you
fix
know
your face, bro.
You know I know.
Why are you listening to me, man?
You know
hey, listen. This is, now you,
you know
I think
I
you actually,
now
you're
know
trying to be
I
funny,
know.
Bro.
No.
You're
know
playing with me, bro.
No, you're playing with me.
So
right
say
now.
It then. Tell
you're
me.
With me right now.
Tell me.
You're playing with me. Come on.
Tell me why.
Tell me about Acts 2:38.
We just read it, brother.
How many wives have you guys got?
Verse 39.
How many wives you got?
And it shall be unto you for a fringe,
That
you may look upon it and remember all the commandments of the Lord and do them.
That's why.
Hey, but what did they do before that? Why did they have to wear them?
What do you mean? Sir, yes, that's why we have to wear them now. That's why we have to wear them now. You're sinning now.
Sin. I told these guys.
Wait a minute.
Earlier.
Hold on. You said that. What did Jesus say?
Earlier.
Matthew's 5.
I told these guys that.
Matthew's 5, 17.
That they wear these fringes because they sinned.
You
I
too.
Told you like that
you
long
sin?
Long ago.
So you don't sin?
You're coming up here short.
You don't sin?
You're coming up here late.
Do you sin?
I already addressed that a long
that.
Time ago.
I don't know. I don't know.
You're coming up here late.
Matthew's 5, 17.
I don't know what you're doing.
Matthew the 5, verse 17. Think not. That I have come to destroy the law or the prophets.
Read.
I am not come to destroy, but to fulfill.
Read.
For verily I say unto you, till heaven and earth pass, one jot or one tittle
Read.
Shall in no wise pass from the law till all be fulfilled.
Read on.
Whosoever therefore shall break one of these least commandments.
Brother, you don't got fringes on. You breaking one of the least commandments. Come on.
And shall teach men so.
You out here with your bullhorn trying to get people to be like you.
And that's very observant of you.
Exactly. And that's very evil. That is very evil of you to do that. It says he that what?
Who whosoever shall break one of these least commandments and shall teach men so, he shall be called the least in the kingdom of heaven.
He shall be called what?
The least in the kingdom of heaven.
He shall be called the least in the kingdom of heaven. Where's the law against wearing the white man's shoe? Notice I attacked your questions. What law is that? And where is that in the Bible? Sir, sir, when did that come out of my mouth?
All the time.
When did you hear me say that just
all
now?
All the time. You come
Lake Sir, when did you hear me say that? Where? Oh, so let's go back to the subject. Yeah. Where is it evil to wear boots, or did you say the white man's shoe? So where is that evil in the Bible?
Where is it evil? Just according to you, it's evil.
You didn't hear us say that. You're lying now.
You come
I thought you loved God.
You're
lying. I'm bearing false witness because I'm saying you're lying. Come on, bro. Hey, give me that.
This is Sirach.
It's the Rock 5.
That.
Hand over your mouth. You know what I'm talking about?
Come up
here real late. Ecclesiastes, the fifth chapter. Let me see.
You need to get one, okay?
Watch this, bro.
You need to get one, okay?
Start it.
You need to get one. Yeah, your helpers out here.
5 and 18.
There are your helpers out here, right? I'm just one person, but guess what? I'm just
right
one person
12.
Today. I'm just one person today.
Listen.
Apocrypha.
Matter of fact, start at 11.
Go
start at 10.
Apocrypha.
Go ahead.
The book of Sirach, chapter 5, verse 10. Be steadfast in thy understanding.
You are the example of a person needing to be steadfast in thy understanding. Come on.
And let thy word be the same.
Let thy word be the same, which is sincerity. One thing that y'all gonna learn about us is that we actually love our nation. We love you blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. We out here to make us one and to come back. But the devil, he don't want to see that. He don't want to see that. You are a devil. He are of your father, the devil. Read on.
Be swift.
I do know your name. I do know your name. Jesse Lee. Oh, Jesse Lee Peterson. Read on. You thought we didn't recognize you, didn't you? You thought we didn't recognize you. Come on, Jesse. Read on.
Be swift to hear.
Jesse, be swift to hear, read.
And let thy life be sincere.
Come on.
And with patience,
Come on.
Give answer.
You what?
Give answer.
You can't answer anything that I ask you. Why is that? But you out here with a bullhorn. Read on.
If thou hast understanding.
Here's fundamentals. If you got understanding, read.
Answer thy neighbor.
Notice I've answered everything that you said. Read on.
If not, lay thy hand upon thy mouth.
Jesse, it's time to shut up, Jesse. Jesse Peter, that is you. That is you. I see you. We know it's you. That's why you trying to hide your face. You trying to hide your face behind the American flag. We see you, Jesse. You're not fooling nobody up here. Read that again.
If not, lay thy hand upon thy mouth.
You're supposed to shut the hell up whenever you don't know what you're talking about. But we got old prideful men out here who think they know the word of God. We got old prideful fools that want to spill their rhetoric like they know what they're talking about. You are not going to succeed here. We got the real mission at hand. We out here to raise up God's people. And that's something about all of y'all. You blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans are the Israelites. And there's nothing wrong with you being called by your God-given name. We are the chosen people of the Most High God. And Satan knows that his time is almost up. Give me that Revelation 12. Revelation the 12th chapter. This is why he is dispatched coons like the ones we see him before us right here. This man, yes, you're a coon. You certified. You got your certification today, brother. Yeah, okay, good. He was right. He was absolutely right. Give me that. Revelation 12. You know what I want? But a short time. Go ahead.
Yeah, the Bible says,
Revelation the 12th and verse 9.
I'm a coon.
And the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent called the devil and Satan, which deceived the whole world. He was cast out on the earth, and his angels were cast out with him.
Hey, listen. Do you realize the doctrine you under? I'm sorry.
Verse 12.
You got it. You understand the reason why you're doing what you're doing? It's because the spirit inside of you is causing you to come out here and stand before your people. That same thing was going on back then. You got the same spirit as Judas Iscariot, brother. Do you understand that? Why is that? You love the other nations more than you love your own, bro. Read, this is why he's out here, read.
Verse 12, therefore rejoice ye heavens, and he that dwell in them. Woe to the inhabitants of the earth.
It says woe to the inhabitants of the earth, read.
And of the sea.
Come on.
For the devil is come down unto you,
read,
having great wrath, because he knoweth that he hath but a short time.
He hath but a short time. In this time we're living in right now, the devil is dispatching coons like Jesse right here. This man spent the majority of his military career scrubbing toilets and licking boots. He was the perfect picking to come against his people. He's been destroyed to the point of no return. Now he wants to stand against us. Now he wants to stand against the prophets of God. Little does he know, it ain't gonna work. We still gonna get the kingdom. God's people still gonna wake up. It's time to come out of these fake churches taking your money. It's time to come out of these false religions. God is real and his son is black, brothers and sisters. It's time. Even though you don't want to see it, it's gonna happen. Give me what's that, Romans 13:11. Romans 13:11. Now you mad because I got you pent, brother. You know that's you, bro. Read that, Romans 13:11.
Romans 13:11.
Come on.
And that, knowing the time, that now it is high time to awake out of sleep.
It's high time for us to wake out of sleep. This man is a product of the Christian church, the so-called church. He is a product of destruction. As a man, you should be able to deal with another man. You should be able to talk and have an intellectual conversation. But you can't do that. You can't do that. You know why? Because you hate God. This is what our people deal with in battle. We ain't gonna waver. We're not gonna do like this man did and give up. We gonna continue to study the word and change our lives. Right now, he's standing in front of me, and all we did was teach blacks, Hispanics, Native Americans to be fathers, to raise up their families, to come out of these streets and quit doing drugs. But this Negro's in front of me. Jesse got an issue with me. All we've taught is the women to be mothers, to take care of their children, to stop being hoes and prostitutes. And this nigga wanna come against me. He is a product of America. Niggas was made in America. And it's time for us to quit being niggas, y'all. It's time for us to be who we really are. The children of Israel. Read that again.
And that, knowing the time,
come on,
that now it is high time to awake out of sleep.
Come on.
For now is our salvation nearer than we believe.
The time is short, brothers. The time is short, sisters. Family, Christ is coming. And if you don't know the Lord, if you don't know God in that day, it ain't gonna be no good for you, brothers and sisters.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road. Purple and gold, from Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.